Good morning.
I'd
like to welcome everyone here this evening, or this morning. Boy, I'm getting ahead of myself. I'd like to see everyone here this morning as we have our children's Christmas program this morning in conjunction with our service. So it's great seeing everyone here this morning. And we pray that the Lord will bless the service and bless the children as they share the message this morning. So there won't be a sermon this morning, so the children will be given the message. So I ask you to really intently listen to what they're sharing with us this morning as the Lord fills us with His Word. With that in mind, I ask you to follow along. There are some congregational parts of the program, some congregational recitations, and some congregational singing, so please keep that note this morning. Everything is on the printed order of service, so all you have to do is follow along with this morning. With that in mind, let's go ahead and welcome everyone, and let's go ahead and begin with our first hymn, Away in a Manger. I ask that you stand on the final verse of that hymn, Away in a Manger. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Jesse tree, Christ's family tree,
points us away to Jesus.
From Eden down to Calvary,
our loving Savior frees us.
The promise is for you and for me.
It points away to Jesus.
Please be seated.
Isaiah 11, 1 through 4, 6. There shall come forth a shoot from the stump of Jesse, and a branch from his root shall bear fruit. and the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. And his delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. He shall not judge by what his eyes see, or decide disputes by what his ears hear. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. The wolf shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the young goat, and the calf and the lion, and the fattened calf together, and a little child shall lead them.
Isaiah 9, 6 through 7. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there will be no end. On the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and righteousness from this time forth and forevermore.
The first promise of a Savior, written in Genesis 3, 1 through 6, 14 and 15. Now the serpent was more crafty than any other beast of the field that the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, "Did God actually say, 'You shall not eat of any tree in the garden?'" And the woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden, but God said, 'You shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the midst of the garden, neither shall you touch it, lest you die.'" But the serpent said to the woman, "You will not surely die, for God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was to be desired to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. And she also gave some to her husband, who was with her, and he ate.
The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all livestock and above all beasts of the field. On your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and between her offspring. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel."
Now Eve and Adam were the first, and through their sin the world was cursed. But by God's love these two were blessed, and through their fruit we too find rest.
Genesis 12, 1 through 3. Now the Lord said to Abram, go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you. And I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great, so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and him who dishonors you, I will curse. And in you all the families of the earth shall be blessed.
Genesis 22, 6 through 8. And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it on Isaac his son. And he took in his hand the fire and the knife. So they went, both of them together. And Isaac said to his father Abraham, my father. And he said, here I am, my son. He said, behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for the burnt offering? Abraham said, God will provide for himself a lamb for the burnt offering, my son.
God's promise of a son came true. This joy through Isaac Sarah knew. This boy, this gift from Abraham, was saved by God who sent a ram.
Samuel 16:1. The Lord said to Samuel, I will send you to Jesse the Bethlehemite, for I have provided for myself a king among his sons.
1 Chronicles 11:1-3. Then all Israel gathered together to David at Hebron and said, the Lord your God said to you, you shall be shepherd of my people Israel, and you shall be prince over my people Israel. So all the elders of Israel came to the king at Hebron, and David made a covenant with them at Hebron before the Lord, and they anointed King David king over Israel according to the word of the Lord by Samuel.
This David shepherd, lowly boy, was blessed by
Matthew 1:1-17. The book of the genealogy of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. So all the generations from Abraham to David were 14 generations. And from David to the deportation to Babylon, 14 generations. And from the deportation to Babylon to the Christ, 14 generations.
Luke 1:26-33. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying, and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end."
Thank you, kids, for sharing with us the Christmas message this morning. We continue with the congregational hymn, Gentle Mary Laid Her Child. As the congregation, please stand as we continue the prayers of the church. We pray together that first petition as is printed in our order of service this morning. Father in heaven, you sent your Son, the Son of Adam, of Jesse, of David. You promised the Messiah through a special family tree. Thank you for making us all sons and daughters in your family through our Savior, Jesus Christ. In his name we pray.
Amen.
O Lord, Almighty God, there is none like you in holiness, constancy, and might. Yet you exercise your power for the salvation of sinners. As we draw near to the celebration of Jesus' birth, fill our hearts with gratitude with your Son, humbled himself and became flesh to bear our sin and to be our Savior. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O Lord, mighty God, Bethlehem was too small to be among the clans of Judah. Yet from it came forth the King of Kings. Remember the congregations of your people where numbers are small and resources are scarce. Provide for their needs and remind them that the Lord of Lords dwells among them in his means of grace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Lord, mighty God, you make poor and you make rich. Receive our thanks for your gifts of daily bread. Give us contentment with what you provide. Preserve us from coveting what you do not give, and grant that we may be wise stewards of all of your blessings. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
O Lord, mighty God, you sent your Son to shepherd his flock in strength and to be great to the ends of the earth. Grant wisdom to our leaders and peace among the nations that we dwell in security. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
O Lord, mighty God, you are our fortress and our protector in every storm of life. We thank you for keeping us safe in the recent wind and storm that came through our area. We pray for those who have lost loved ones, that you would comfort them with the hope that we have in Christ. And for those who have lost or have damaged property, that you provide for them also in their time of rebuilding and recovery efforts. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our
O Lord, mighty God, you helped your servant Israel, and your mercy endures forever. Look upon those who are brought low by illness, injury, grief, or any other affliction. We especially remember Emma Walters, Darlene Dinsey, Marianne Waller, Kathleen Barone, Patty Simonson, Gary Wilhelm, Ashley Bremer, Pastor Donald Cooper, Lane Otmer, Esther Beathy, Mary Mommins, Shirley Bartles, Laverne Bartles, Wake Spoodle, Jeanette Noble, Sophie Carnegie, Sean Otmer, Steve Fry, Declan Heineman, Brianna Posberg, Ellen DeYoung, and Jim Bornpohl. Have mercy upon them and grant them healing and strength, and maintain them in the certain hope of your faithfulness to them for Jesus' sake. Lord, in your mercy. O Lord, mighty God, you have sanctified us through the sacrifice of Jesus Christ once for all on the cross. Prepare the hearts of all who commune this day with penitence and trust in your promises, and so make us holy with your Son's body and blood. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
O Lord, mighty God, you have done great things for us, and most of all, by delivering us from death to life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Mercifully hear our prayers and answer them according to your will for the sake of your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We now confess our faith, Christian faith, in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please be seated as we gather our offerings this morning. I invite the congregation to please stand as we continue with confession and absolution this morning. Let us confess our sins to God our Father. Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
What is the sacrament of the altar? What is the benefit of this eating and drinking? How can bodily eating and drinking do such great things? The sacrament worthily. Our Lord Jesus Christ, in the night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also after supper he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen.
Steadfast in the truth, faith, the life everlasting, the heart of his peace. Amen.
Let me go up here.
Thank you.
invite you to stand as we pray the post-communion collect. Let us pray. We give thanks to you, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us with this salutary gift. We implore you that of your mercy you would strengthen us with the same in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And receive the Lord's benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and grant you his peace. Amen. Please be seated for our closing hymn, hymn 388, Go Tell It on the Mountain. Lord's richest blessings be with each and every one of you. Just a few announcements this morning. I'd like to say thank you to all those who are involved with the children's program. Thank you, kids, for the wonderful job of singing and sharing with us God's word this morning. Thank you to Deborah and Madeline, our teachers, for organizing all this. Thank you to you, parents and grandparents, for coming and being with us this morning. Also, thank you to Jen and Loretta for playing the keyboard and organ this morning, and to Dave Borenpohl for the cross up here this morning. So thank you very much to all those who are involved with the program today. Hopefully I didn't forget anybody. Just a couple things here. Most announcements I'm going to commend to your care and reading. There's a couple thank yous for cards that were sent over Thanksgiving. So, you know, the shut-ins really appreciate that, and or those that can't get here on Sunday morning, so that they really appreciate that. We are still gathering cards in the back for our shut-ins for Christmas. So if you haven't already done so, please consider writing out those cards and plopping them in there. If you have any questions, feel free to talk to Cheryl, and she'd be happy to answer any questions that you might have with that. Let's see here. There's a grief support group that's going to begin on January 9th. This is going to be a weekly support group that's going to be meeting. It's going to start on the 9th at 4 o'clock at the Tecumseh Library. So this is being organized by Patty Holtis and their family, and the memorials from Dave Holtis are kind of going to support this. So if you know anybody who is struggling with grief, certainly there might be many during this time of year, direct them towards this grief group for that wonderful time of support that would provide. Also, this week, there's a lot of things happening as we continue to celebrate our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ's birth. Starting this evening at 7 o'clock, we'll have our Christmas cantata. And so I'd like to invite you all back here for that cantata. It's just going to be really beautiful. So please invite family, invite friends to come on over. If for some reason you can't make it, or maybe don't feel comfortable driving at night, we'll be live streaming it on St. John's Facebook page. I'd like to thank St. Peter's for lending us their equipment to do that this evening. But we'll also be posting it on our YouTube after the performance this evening. So I'm not exactly sure when that's going to get up, but it'll get up sometime this evening for that. Also, this Friday is Christmas Eve, and so we'll have our Christmas Eve candlelight service. That's going to be here at 7:30. And then on Saturday, on Christmas Day, we'll have our Christmas festival service. That'll begin with Holy Communion, and that's going to be at 10:30 in the morning. And then our Sunday morning service, which already is going to be the first Sunday after Christmas, that's going to be at 10:30 again on next Sunday. So what a wonderful way that God has provided for us this year, where we can spend the entire weekend with Him and come and to hear His word and receive His gifts to us. And so I'd like to invite you to come and receive those gifts, again, starting this evening with the Christmas cantata. Any announcements that didn't make it in that should be? Yes, Kevin.
I just want to add to the cantata, Pastor, that there's a reception following that we'll have a little fellowship with cookies and
okay. Thank you. So, yes, I forgot to mention. Thank you so much. After the cantata this evening, there will be refreshments, hot apple cider cookies and so forth. So, again, come for the cantata and then stay for time of goodies and refreshments afterwards. Knowing that some of you might not be with us over Christmas, that you might be traveling, so I'd just like to say a Merry Christmas from my family to yours, that you have a blessed Christmas with your family. Safe travels as you travel about, and pray that the Lord will bless you, and look forward to seeing you back here soon. God's richest blessings to all of you.